Something else, isn't it? Yeah, that's Oscar's tune. Obviously. He wrote it for his first wife. Blues for Big Scotia. And that's what he called her, Scotia. She's a pretty good sized woman. Of course, he was a pretty good sized man, too. They had four children amongst them. She was from Nova Scotia, obviously, for Scotia. But more importantly, I would like for you to put your hands together and acknowledge the wonderful talent that this man has right here. Dwight Kilian. You're hearing creativity in its best and its kind, believe me. And last but not least, this young man here on drums, playing so tastefully, Ryan Anthony. Oscar was born in Montreal, Canada, on August 15th. The day after my birthday, actually. Leo, born in 1925 to a family of four. His father was a porter for the Canadian Pacific Railway. And he would make the weekly trip from Montreal to British Columbia, stay overnight, turn around, and come back. And this was a weekly routine for Oscar's father. And during this time when Papa was away, the children weren't at play. Oscar had a sister by the name of Daisy who was a few years older than he, and she was a fine pianist, not a jazz pianist, but a classical pianist. They were very young, And they were studying classical music, Bach, Beethoven, Mozart. And hearing Oscar play, you can certainly tell that he was definitely schooled very much so in the classics, or he wouldn't have been able to play the way he did. But the point was that Papa Peterson made up a practice book. And the kids were to make note every day they practiced, the date they played, the hour they started, and the hour they finished, or the minutes they finished, or whatever. And then when Pop would come home, they would hand him the practice book, and he would look it over very, very carefully. And then they would sit down and play their lessons for him. He took great pride in their growth and in their progress. Well, Oscar moved on, obviously, as we know, through a wonderful career spanning years of performances all over the United States, all over Europe, Canada, you name it, every country you can think of he performed in, through the auspices of jazz at the Philharmonic. And I must tell you this story because this is how he was discovered. In 1949, Oscar was playing in Montreal, Canada with a trio. And Ray Brown was a member of this band at the time. And they were just playing and gigging and having fun and this kind of stuff. But Oscar was well known in Montreal at the time. And Norman Granz had flown into Montreal to do some business for the Jazz Philharmonic. And he was in a taxi cab heading for the airport. And he's bopping along, and he's got to catch a red eye from Montreal to New York, because he had business there. And the taxi cab driver had a radio going, and here's this great jazz piano happening. And Norman says to the taxi cab driver, he says, "Hey, who's this? Who's this guy here?" He says, "Don't you know who this is?" The guy says, "No, no." So I ask, "Who is this fella?" And he was very stern about the questions. And he says, "Well, this is Oscar Peterson. He's well known here in Montreal." Norman says, turn the cab around. He says, "Where's this guy playing?" He says, "A place called On the Town Tavern. Take me there." Rest is history. Norman walks into the tavern, sits down unannounced. Oscar had no idea who he was. Norman heard three or four tunes. He took a break, and Norman signed him right there for Clef Records and for the Philharmonic. That was 1948-49. And Norman wound up being Oscar's manager, wound up being Ella's manager, Ray's manager, and a few other managers of bands of musicians that were in the Philharmonic. They traveled the world. I heard this group in 1955 in Seattle at the Civic Auditorium. This is the first time I heard Oscar play live with Ray Brown and Barney Kessel on guitar. And what a group that was. And I was 18 years old at that time. But I had discovered Oscar way before then, which I'll tell you a little later, okay? I'd like to continue on with an Oscar composition. We're going to change the schedule there a little bit, fellas. We're going to go from Tranquillism, we're going to go to Wheatland. The tune we're about to do for you is from a collection of pieces titled The Canadiana Suite. Oscar was commissioned by the Prime Minister of Canada at the time, this was like early middle 60s, to write various compositions depicting the various provinces of his native Canada, starting from Montreal or from Quebec all the way to British Columbia. Well, this tune's titled Wheatland, which covers Saskatchewan and Alberta, which has rolling, like Kansas, rolling wheat fields and so on and so forth, and which Oscar had seen many times when he's traveling with his dad, taking a trip on the train. So this is what Oscar did. He took the trip on the Canadian Pacific Railway from Montreal, and he would sit in the observation car, and he would sketch music that would apply to the various provinces that he was seeing. And this is one of them. We'd like to do it for you now, called Wheatland.
Thank you.
Ryan Anthony happens to be from the good old state of Indiana. You know, and there's no bridge in Indiana either, you know. Ryan is a young man, as we all were one time. And I'll tell you, the way he's playing this afternoon, he's got a brilliant future ahead of him. Wouldn't you agree? I'm really proud of Ryan because he worked very hard at ASU. A graduate, got his bachelor's, and just recently finished his master's. Yeah, that deserves another round of applause. He's also teaching school. And like the rest of us, in his business, surviving and playing gigs. But he's playing them well. And Ryan, you're really playing great. Thank you. Now, the man on bass here happens to be from the state of Kansas. Now, we all know where Kansas is. I sure do. I lived in this state 2 years. Dwight was born in a little town. As you're driving into it, there's a big billboard that says, "Welcome to Russell, wheat capital of the world." Town consists of two old soreheads and a loser. Russell, Kansas, right in the heart of the wheat belt. And I mean, you can look for miles. When these people harvest wheat, there's like 20 combines in one field, and they're all offset. And they all are cutting these big swaths. Acres after acres after acres of wheat in Russell, Kansas. And I'm sure glad that Russell produced this young man, because I definitely love this young man. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. This man is so talented, it's scary. He is so talented, and not only that, he's one beautiful human being. Dwight Kilian, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Anthony on drums. Stand up, Ryan. Dwight Kilian on bass. Oscar's arrangement of Sweet Georgia Brown. I'm Armand Boatman. Now here's Bishop McManus.
Great band, huh? About 10 minutes, we got time outside, coffee, chocolates, ambiance.
Thank you.
As you probably guess, that's an Oscar piece from his Canadiana suite, and he titled it Blues of the Prairie, which is a fun little piece to play. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for coming back for a second set. There's a man here I want to acknowledge who deserves a lot of credit, and he's put a lot of work into this, it's obvious, because he believes in what he's doing. That goes without saying, but he has a great vision. We all have to have vision, because if we don't, we're not gonna make it. And this man is doing very, very well here at God's house. The Jazz at the Church originator. Would you please put your hands together and thank Bishop McManus. We have Dwight. We have Dwight Kilian on bass. And we have Ryan Anthony on drums. Before our time runs out, there's a lot of people during the break ask me, well, how'd you get involved here with Oscar? I mean, you know, you're just listening to some things? Oh, yes. When I was 11 years old, there was a man who owned a music store in my hometown, and he was a friend of my father's. And it was my birthday, and he comes up to me, he says, Armand, I've got a birthday present for you. And he reaches down behind the counter and pulls out volume 14 of Jazz at the Philharmonic, Norman Granz. Now, I had no idea. Now, I'm a farm boy, okay? 155-acre farm, milking cows, doing other things that a farmer does. I never heard of Oscar Peterson before, and he says, there's a guy here I want you to hear. Take this home and listen to it. And then next week, come back and tell me what you think. I said, okay. Well, I could hardly wait to get home. I put Oscar's album on, and the first cut was Tenderly. Well, I'm sitting there on a footstool. My mother is standing behind me, and folks, I want you to know that that was a spiritual experience for me. By listening to this man play for the first time in my life at 11 years old. I looked up at my mother and I said, Ma'am, I says, this is who I want to be. This is who I want to sound like. I finally found it. I'm going for it. And she says, he plays wonderfully, doesn't he? I said, oh, yes. Well, that's how it all started at 11 years of age. Then later on in my life, I thought, you know, I hope the time comes that I'm able to meet Oscar and tell him this story. Yeah, it happened. Scottsdale Center of the Arts, he was performing a solo concert. And after the concert, I went backstage. He's sitting back there in a chair talking to some people. So I patiently waited, and I took my turn, and I went up and introduced myself. And I said, hi, Oscar. Huge hand. Huge man, 350 pounds worth, about like this. And I said, I have something to tell you. I know that there's been millions of people pay you worthwhile accolades and compliments. I'm here to do the same. But this accolade that I'm going to tell you, this compliment I'm going to give you, comes from here. Okay? I said, you taught me how to play jazz. I did. I said, yes. He said, well, you're never in any of my schools. I said, yes, I was. I was in a school of listening. I listened to you play over and over and over and over again until I almost drove my family crazy. But I said, I learned, and you taught me. And I'm here to tell you and to thank you for that opportunity. I've thought about this day, and now it has arrived. And I said, Oscar, I owe it all to you, man. I said, you've done it for me. He gets up out of this chair, comes over to me, and he opens up this big torso, and he puts his arms around me, and he gives me one of the biggest bear hugs I've ever had in my life. And he's doing this. He's dancing with me, and I was a poor dancer because my feet were dangling off the floor. So I happened to look up, and hear tears coming down his eyes. And there was tears coming down mine. And we hugged, and then he put me down on the floor. Gently. And I said, Oscar, thanks, man, for all you've done. He says, hold on a minute. He says, I want you to walk out with me to the hotel. I said, okay, great, be happy to. It was in January, so the weather was nice in Scottsdale. So we're walking out the door, and his hotel was over to the right. He says, man, he says, this is wonderful weather. He says, it's colder than it can be up in Montreal. He says, the snow's aside. He says, I could get used to this kind of thing. I said, well, I'll tell you something. You know, I was on cloud 25, walking with the king here, the Pope, all right? And I said, I tell you what, if you ever want to come to visit, you can be the guest in my home. I will shield you from the press. No one will know that you're here. And I said, you can stay with me as long as you want. I'll meet you at the airport. Nobody needs to know you're in town. I'll feed you. I'll drive you around, show you the sights, the whole nine yards. He says, that sounds great. I may take you up on that. I said, okay. So we bid goodnight. I get in the car, and I'm in shock. Driving all the way home, I'm thinking, oh. I don't have a bed strong enough to support this lovely man. Plus, I don't have a refrigerator big enough to feed him. One more story and then I'll shut up. Milt Jackson told me this story. Norman Granz and the Count Basie Band were performing in New York City at Carnegie Hall. Oscar was on the bill, Ella was on the bill, Basie and the Modern Jazz Quartet. Well, after the concert was over, Norman would always feed the band. So they all went into this big banquet room, and the waiters were standing around waiting to take their orders. So Norman's at one end of this long table, the band, everybody was kind of, but Oscar's sitting at the other end. So the waitresses and the waiters were moving around, taking people's orders. Menus were in order, so on and so forth. So they came to Oscar. And the waitress says, Mr. Peterson, what would you like to order? He looks it over. He says, I would like to order all of page one. They did. Three busboys sat there with all this food, and he ate everything, and they could not believe what they were seeing. True story. Now I'm going to finish and play. Okay? I want to thank you all for being here. It's been a pleasure to perform for you. It always is a pleasure to perform for you, because that's why I'm here, to play for you and to entertain you and to make you feel good. And to sort of lighten the burdens of our lives these days. And again, these fellows right here, I couldn't do it by myself. I just couldn't. And would you help me thank one more time Dwight Kilian? And on drums. This young man, it's what a pleasure. He had one rehearsal with me, and the charts were sketched. He put them all together in 2 hours. And you're hearing the results tonight. How about a nice hand for Ryan Anthony? Something I said? Well, thank you. Thank you. We'd like to do another Oscar tune. Now, this came along in Oscar's career a little later on when he, right before he had his stroke. And this is a beautiful piece. And we like, Dwight and I are going to do this for you as a duo. And the tune is titled Love Ballad.
Thank you.
Isn't that a pretty piece? Indeed. You could also write, obviously, and feel. That's sort of a la Chopin here. So, A, I've got many more stories, but I'm not going to bore you with them because I know too many about Oscar. But I love him. I miss him. He's my mentor. He'll always be my mentor. We all have to have mentors somewhere or another. And I'm very fortunate, and I thank God he came into my life. Because what you're hearing, you can thank Oscar tonight for what you're hearing. Don't give me the credit. You give God the credit, and you give Oscar the credit. I'd like to do now, I'm featuring Ryan, on a tune from a trombone player of all folks, Juan Tazal, a tune called Caravan. Thank you.
put on tour for you. But before I go, and we go, I want you to know what a privilege it is to be alive, and what a privilege it is to play. You don't know what it means, folks, but you know what it is to be alive and to breathe. And that we are all sharing and doing. So I think this closing tune is appropriate. And it was written by a marvelous maestro, a marvelous musician. Oscar had recorded this, and others, Bill Evans. So I want to pass it on to you. It's a beautiful piece, and it's called Some Other Time.
very much, ladies and gentlemen. Good night. Come back. Thank you so much. Dwight Kilian, Ryan Anthony, Bishop McManus.